As you all may have heard from me in the past, my laptop behind me has no muscle whatsoever, which makes it a little challenging for editing and rendering video. It has 16 gigs in it, but unfortunately the laptop is about 5 or 6 years old. It might be more than that. I have lost track, but the processor in it isn't that powerful. Now, if you watch some of my earlier videos from the beginning of when I finally started the channel, you will notice that sometimes at some point in the duration of the video, most of the time it happens towards the middle all the way up until the end, my mouth will be moving and the audio will be lagged behind. Now, there were many people on the internet given different options for fixing this in Premiere, and one of them was changing the extension of the file from .mp4 to .move, I believe. That didn't seem to work for me. I've heard it work for other people. I was having no change in my videos. It was still doing it after rendering the video. It wasn't just after rendering the video. It happened during editing, and it was making it really hard for me to actually edit the video and get the cuts where I wanted them. But I have since then found a remedy to that. If you guys happen to have a laptop with not much power, just like I do, you might want to check this out, this episode of We Get Technical. Welcome back to another episode of We Get Technical, and today we're talking about my process for editing video all the way up until the end, and how I deal with audio being off in Premiere, what I found to fix that, and all the steps that I go through when rendering a video for YouTube. Now, you will also notice as I'm going through this, this is the whole reason why it takes me a little longer than most people who have a powerful computer to get videos up on YouTube. Now, I was in the process of saving for a new laptop. That unfortunately is not happening. I was going to get a MacBook Pro, but unfortunately that money had to go to other bills. It's really upsetting. I really did want a new laptop, but for now, I'm stuck with this guy. Let's find out the process that I go through for editing video. Now, obviously, the first step is what we're doing right now is recording the video. Once you get the video recorded, you get it onto your laptop or your desktop. Either way, this is for PC. I'm sure this will work for Mac as well. Once the video is on your computer, you're going to want to use a software called Handbrake. I will leave a link in the description down below. You're going to want to convert your video. Now, for some odd reason, when you record a video, it won't keep a constant frame rate, and that's why the audio is coming later on after your mouth is moving. At least that's what I've seen. And you're going to want to go into the software Handbrake, load the video, and then once you get the video loaded, you're going to want to change some of the settings. I normally check to see what the resolution of the video. It's normally 1920 by 1080. All right, after that, what I normally do is I go into the video tab, and in that tab, I change a couple of settings, one of them being the frame rate. Now, my cell phone normally captures video at 29.78, 29.97 frame rate per second. So I normally, most people put it at 30. I'm probably in the future going to go ahead and try to make it 30 frames per second. But for now, I've been keeping with the 29.97. And then I click constant frame rate. Now what that's going to do is going to keep the same frame rate throughout the entirety of the video. Then I go down and change the encoder profile to high, and then I change the encoder level to 4.2. Now this is normally the settings I use when I'm rendering video in Premiere anyway, so I kind of like to stick with that. And then I change the encoder preset to slow. Now the slower that you can take, the better. That's going to give you a better quality video, and also it's going to bring down the size of that file, that video file, which is also good. I mean, because normally when these videos are done, they're like in the gigs, and you're going to want to bring that file size down without losing any quality, and that's what this Handbrake converter will do. Now, obviously, this process, if your computer's like mine, is going to take a while. It's really slow. It takes some time to get the video converted, But once it's done and converted, then I have to go and convert this again, unfortunately. So I'm converting one video twice, and all I'm changing at this point is the resolution. I change it down to 640 by 360. And the reason I do this and make another video file is because you will notice if your computer is slow and you get that video into Premiere, the video will be choppy, and it makes it really challenging to edit a video that's moving like this. So I changed the resolution down to 640 because it allows the video for the most part to run smoothly. So I'll go, once I bring that 1920 video in the Premiere, I'll replace the footage with 640. When I'm done editing that video, I will then replace it again with the 1920, so you can go back up to full HD when you render the video. For me, this has seemed to help. It makes it easier to edit the video. The only thing is that this process takes forever. It takes really long. Once you start to actually render the video, you will see it can take a long time with a computer such as mine that has not much muscle to it. And then once I actually get that video rendered, half the time it's over a gig, sometimes two. The other day I had a video that was 4 gigs, and that was the video for testing those multiple controllers on the Super RetroKit. If you haven't seen that video, I will leave a link in the description down below. It was 4 gigs, and after rendering that, I obviously had to convert this video once again because I needed to bring that file size down, because I did not want to go putting 4 gigs on the YouTube. So as you can see, this process is quite lengthy, and this is why it takes me forever to get videos up on YouTube. I try to do my best. I try to at least get a video up a week. It doesn't always work that way. I mean, for God's sakes, the only time I do record videos is on the weekend, and then it takes me a while to get these things converted, edited, and up. If you have a computer that has a really crappy processor, it's really slow, this will help you, but it is going to take quite some time to finally get a final render of the video that's ready to be uploaded on YouTube. If you have any questions about any of the steps that I talked about in this episode of We Get Technical, please don't ever hesitate to ask in the comments down below. I will get back to you as soon as possible. It's a really simple process. It's just time consuming. If you liked what you've seen in this video, please as always hit that thumbs up. If you feel this video was of some sort of value, please share amongst your friends. And as always, if you'd like to see more from the We Deem channel, please hit that subscribe button.